Have you ever had one of those random creative thoughts in the shower and decided this was the time to act? Well, this is exactly what this video is. It's Punchy, and today I would like to share my speculations on the importance of food in Deep Woken. A lot of people in the community are questioning several ideas like racial abilities, magic customization, and how weapon interaction will go, but I have something much more important to talk about. It's food. I know what you're thinking. Really? Food? But what the player can eat can inform the player about the world's environment and develop the lore in subtle ways. The worst thing a game can do to portray lore is just giving it right to you. The mystery and subtle things you pick up along the way, that's what really takes a world building experience to another level. Let's start off with things that we know. What food has been shown so far? Well, we know right off the bat that gobletos can be eaten. This was showcased, I believe, in one of the earlier directs as one of our first pieces of information about Deep Woken. Gobletos look to be plants, and they don't look very nourishing, but I think they're quite abundant in parts of the map. In other screenshots and videos, we've seen pots of soup and gruel. Maybe it's stew. When these have been made, I'm not really too enticed, man. Like, eating a bunch of stew, eating a bunch of soup, it does look like prison food. Kinda gross. This food may be bland, but it does give us a peek on how Deep Woken will be more of a survival game, where players are not going to be able to choose the nicest things to eat in order to survive. In this leak right here, the player looks quite impoverished, so maybe this is all he can find around in the biome. I know I was making fun of gobletos earlier, but maybe they are really quite important. With seasons being a relevant portion on how winds and weather will work, maybe the fall and winter seasons could remove all the food, like gobletos, off the surface of the grass. If you have no food, pretty sure you just screwed. Referencing Agamatsu's video and the abundance of sea in this game, one can assume that fishing will be relevant in the food cooking situation. I'm not sure if the things you can catch are all the same, but maybe some variety based on location could go far for the world building experience. Another piece of information that was provided to us was the addition of boons, and I think curses. I'm not too sure if the negative traits were defined as curses, but I will be calling it that because it's negative. One boon a player could have was gourmet food, and one negative curse was vegetarian. Are vegetarians completely restricted from eating meat, or is it something that is advised? If vegetarians eat vegetables, would it buff them? Maybe if you eat enough of something poisoned, you could generate an immunity or develop a disease. This is interesting to take a look at, because does that mean we can make food that is more advanced than fish caught from the sea or vegetable stews? Perhaps being a cook could be a job or minigame that is in Deep Woken. Another thing I want to discuss is what food will do. Does food allow you to heal faster or run for longer? Does it do nothing? I'm sure it does something, but what could it do? Perhaps potions can be combined with cooked food to produce enhancements. Revisiting that thing about vegetarians. Can vegetarians even eat something that isn't a vegetable, or will it cause them negative effects? As you can see, there's an endless sea of possibility just stemming from the general topic of food. It's like an umbrella that's ready to be opened for so many paths and concepts that could be elaborated upon. Now, something I was really jumping to talk about would be races and their food. Some races in Deep Woken, like the Gremor, or the deer race, could be vegetarian while others are not. I believe this is so because Deep Woken races are inspired of real-life animals, and deers in real life are vegetarian. Unless you're in a Native American graveyard, they're probably not very vegetarian. If the Felinors, the cat race, if they eat fish, will they gain some type of buff? I know that many cats in real life enjoy eating fish, so that could be implemented as well. Another question that's maybe a little bit silly to ask will be, how will Vesperians eat? They all wear masks from what I've seen, and maybe the entire concept of eating food from other players is foreign. I do speculate that this screenshot shown earlier could be a Vesperian without a mask, so maybe they can eat if their masks are broken. Something funny, I think, is the Ganymedes, and Vesperians as well. From what I can notice, they don't have mouths, so maybe they can only eat soup or stew from a portable IV bag that's stabbed into their arms or something. I mean, they really don't have anything to eat the food from. They have a mask on, or they just don't have any mouths. Again, the Vesperians are the mask races, which cover their entire faces, and the Ganymedes are the beetle races, which I haven't seen to have any mouths. Even races like the Lightsworn are a mystery. They literally generate light from above their head or around their arms. Maybe they don't eat normal food if they can produce light. Whatever they're eating, I want to eat. Okay, enough of this video. It may be a little bit joke to some of you guys, but I'm very focused on this food, okay? Like, you don't even understand. That's all I really want to say for now, but I really wanted to stress how important these little details are to building an effective and interesting world with lore. I would love for the developers to see this video and hopefully laugh to themselves about how it's correct or completely off track for their intentions. Anyway, debunking is on the way, so get ready for more food-based commentary, and I will see you on the Grand Line, Etrian Waters. Subscribe if you are interested, and have a nice day.